In this video, I'll walk through a couple of examples of the colligative properties of solutions, specifically that of lowering the freezing point and increasing the boiling point. The first one says, how many liters of the antifreeze ethylene glycol, CH2OH, CH2OH, would you add to a car radiator containing 6.50 liters of water if the coldest winter temperature in your area is negative 20 degrees Celsius? And then we're given the density of ethylene glycol as 1.11 grams per milliliters. We'll need that in a little bit. Now, what happens is, just some background on this, when you add a solute to water or any solvent, it necessarily decreases the freezing point. We know that's going to happen. Now, it's different for different solvents. So for water, we have some specific constants. Now, the interesting thing is, it doesn't matter if we have a huge molecule like this or if we just have something like salt. But salt, of course, would ruin your engine, so we're not going to use salt. Now, we use salt on the roads or some version of it to melt the ice on the roads. So here we go. We are going to use this formula. The change in temperature of the freezing point equals some constant for freezing for water, specific for water, times the molality of the solution. That's the little m, molality. So let's walk through what we have. We say that the change in temperature, we know that's going to be 20 degrees, and we're not going to throw in the negative just because we know that the temperature change in T is always going to go down when we add some solute to a solvent. So I'll just write in 20 right here. Now, some other things that we need to know is this K sub F. Well, for water, we can look this up on a table or on the internet, but I'll give it to you here. For water, the K sub F constant is 1.86 degrees C per molality. So I'll throw that in there, 1.86 degrees Celsius per molality. That'll cancel out the molality, so we're just left with the number of moles is actually what we're going to end up with. Now, this molality, well, the molality equals the moles of the solute divided by the mass of the solvent, and that's in kilograms. Mass of the solvent, assuming that this water has the density of 1 gram per milliliter, then the mass of this water is simply 6.50 kilograms, or 6,500 grams. So I'll put that in there for the mass of the solvent, 6.50 kilograms, and what do we need? That is N, the number of moles of the solute, right here in that formula for molality. Okay, solving for N, then, we get N number of moles equals 69.892 moles of the ethylene glycol, that's abbreviated EG, but we need to know how many liters of this antifreeze to add into our radiator, so I'm just going to go through a conversion here. Here we go, 69.892 moles. We need to convert moles all the way into liters, so first of all I'm going to convert those moles into number of grams, and that is the molar mass. Molar mass of ethylene glycol is 62.07 grams per mole. All right, we canceled out moles with that one. Now we need to convert grams into a volume, and for that we'll use this density. So I'm going to put grams in the denominator, 1.11 grams in the denominator, and 1 milliliter in the numerator. So this is our ratio, 1.11 grams per milliliter. Of course, we can Say that's 1 milliliter point per 1.11 grams. And that's what we did here, so that we could cancel out the grams. And then let's convert that, of course, to liters. And that's not too difficult. We just say 1 liter has 1,000 milliliters, and we put the milliliters in the denominator so that the milliliters would cancel out here. All in the end, put it in blue because we're talking about freezing point, equals 3.91 liters of the ethylene glycol. 3.91 liters of that stuff, plus the 6.5. That sounds about right for the size of a radiator. Getting coming up on, that's a little over 10 liters. Okay, an appropriate size for a radiator. Now let's talk about this. We want to find out the boiling point of the water ethylene glycol mixture. Well, for that we have another formula, and that is the change in temperature for boiling equals some constant for boiling for water times the, you guessed it, molality. So, this constant here is equal to, for water, is 0.52 degrees Celsius per molality. Now, I just want to let you know, this 0.52 and the 1.86, I did not calculate that. So if you feel like, hey, where did he get that number? I didn't calculate it. I looked it up on a table. And so it's just, you have these different constants for different solvents, and we're dealing with the solvent water. So that's why I used that constant, because that is the correct constant for water. Now the molality, M, the molality equals 69.892 moles, that's what we found here, divided by the mass of the solvent, and that is still 6.50 kilograms. So now I've just hard typed the molality right in there. And the change in temperature for the boiling point then is 5.59 degrees Celsius. And we know this is always going to go up or increase. So we will add that to 100 degrees. So the new boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. That's the old, or that is the boiling point of pure water, plus the 5.59 degrees Celsius equals a new boiling point of 105.59 degrees Celsius. Your engine gets much hotter than that. Do not open your radiator cap immediately after driving. That's, it would blow up in your face, well, or at least release a lot of steam in your face. Very dangerous. Let it cool down. Now, I hope you found that very helpful. If you did, please consider liking this video or sharing it with a friend.